Hey, welcome back to the Rebel Tech channel. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to convert this MacBook Pro 15-inch mid-2010 into a Windows laptop. It's for my buddy here who doesn't know how to use macOS, so it's not wrong for him to use Windows on this MacBook. This MacBook is still relevant today in 2024. I've covered this in my previous video. I'll share the link in the description. We won't be installing macOS at all because he doesn't know how to use macOS. I'll be installing either Windows 11 or Windows 10. I've never tested Windows 11 on this model yet. Hopefully I can install Windows 11 on this MacBook Pro. First, you will need the bootable drive, which I'm not able to share. You would have to source yourself Windows 10 and Windows 11 SSD. We're gonna put this aside. What I have here is a Windows laptop. This Windows laptop supports 2.5 inch hard drive. I've already installed the SSD inside here, so I'm gonna be installing Windows 11. Once I'm done, I'll take out the SSD and then I will install on the MacBook Pro. So as you can see, I've already installed Windows 11 here because I try to keep it short. I've already changed the BIOS to legacy mode. So I'll be taking the drive out and then we're gonna install Windows 11 on this MacBook. It's pretty straightforward. Yeah. I'm gonna unscrew. I'm not sure which one is Windows 10. I have Windows 10 and Windows 11 ready. We're doing this outdoor, by the way. I try to rush this because I scared it's gonna rain. So hopefully it doesn't. Okay. Disconnect the battery a bit. Take out the old hard drive. This is for those who doesn't want to use macOS but want to use Windows instead on a MacBook. It's not wrong, it's not illegal, it's fine. Okay, we'll remove the drive. Okay, this is Windows 11, new SSD, pretty cheap, probably 30 bucks. Just want to clean a bit. Okay, I'm just going to dust the fan. Ooh, that's a pretty huge dust. I'm not going to do servicing on this MacBook yet. It's probably in the future videos, or you can refer to my old videos. I'm scared it's going to drizzle or rain, so I don't want to take the risk. Again, I'm doing this outdoor, so expect some noises. People will probably be telling me why don't do this indoor. It's kind of boring. There's no thrill. Wow. Alright, just minor dusting. Not gonna do full servicing, even though my mind tells me to. Just screw this back. I'm actually also opposite a repair shop which does Mac repairs and all that stuff. Okay, so I've already screwed everything back and then let's try the power on. I'm gonna hold option key, alternate key. You'll see Windows here. And I'm gonna click enter, see if it runs. Okay, that's Windows logo. I'm not sure if you can see, it's already booting up to Windows 11. Right. Okay, so I already downloaded the Apple Bootcamp driver. We're gonna install Bootcamp. Okay, Bootcamp drivers, I think it's still installing. It's installing the NVIDIA graphics card. This, fortunately, has NVIDIA graphics card. If it's the AMD, I don't think it would work. So let's just wait for it to finish installation. So basically, I've already installed the Apple Bootcamp drivers for this model, which you can download in macOS. And yeah, I've sort of prepared everything, so I'm gonna do a restart to see if it crashes. I'm gonna hold option. Okay, enter. Okay, so I'm hoping it doesn't crash when the Bootcamp app is loaded. So I'm hoping it doesn't crash. Okay, it crashed. See, I really knew this is gonna happen. WDF violation. The most simplest way is just to disable Bootcamp. Okay, I'm gonna go to safe mode. And then I'll let it crash again until you go to safe mode. I'm on the recovery page. I'm gonna press F8. Okay, I'm gonna go into safe mode. F4. I think it's number 4. So right now it's booting up into safe mode. So I'm gonna go into task manager and then disable Bootcamp manager. So it's already disabled. Then I'll do restart. So now Windows 11 running in normal boot. It won't crash anymore because it doesn't load the Bootcamp application. Okay, so what we did earlier just now is to disable the Bootcamp manager. It's giving us the WDF violation. I already mentioned to my friend that might happen. He's fine with losing access to the right-click what Bootcamp manager offers. You will lose access, keyboard, backlight and all that stuff. So he's fine with that. You can use a wireless mouse only if you're running Windows 11. That's actually a way I could have just installed on a MacBook Pro 15-inch 2012 non-retina and then I'll just install Windows Bootcamp there and then transfer the drive onto this model. You won't have that issue at all. So I've installed Windows 11 on a Windows laptop and then I transferred the SSD onto this MacBook, which is why I also prepared Windows 10 in case he wanted Windows 10 but he wanted Windows 11. So I'm done and he can use this MacBook running Windows 11. You can refer on my previous video, I'm gonna share the link in the description. That's how you convert a Mac into a Windows laptop. Some people will probably say, why use Windows on a Mac? To be honest, it's pretty good because this is a 2010 model. It's probably 14 years old. 14 years old, 2024. Yeah, it's 14 years old. And you can still use it in 2024. It's fine. Thank you so much for joining me in this video. I hope you guys learned something today. And yep, thank you. Bye-bye.